Afternoon countdown is everywhere. I notice Carol has got the moon. I recognise the moon dress, the contours of the moon.
Enough.
It's looking very good, Carol. Listen, this email here, when I joined the show, I think it's 270-odd shows ago.
I thought you were about to say 270-odd years ago.
No, I'm not that old, Carol. Yeah. I've got an email here. It's an amazing story about an email that went wrong, right? A Toronto couple decided to go to Florida to thaw out during a particularly icy winter. They planned to stay at the same hotel where they'd spent their honeymoon 20 years earlier. But because of hectic schedules, the husband left and flew to Florida on the Thursday, with his wife flying down the following day. The husband checked into the hotel room, and there was a computer in his room. So he decided, even though he wasn't au fait with them, to send an email to his wife. However, he actually and accidentally left out one letter in her email address. And without realizing his error, he sent the email. Meanwhile, somewhere in Houston, a widow had just returned home from her husband's funeral. He was a minister who had had a heart attack and passed away. The widow decided to check her email, expecting messages from relatives and friends. After reading the first message, she screamed and fainted. The widow's son rushed into the room and saw the computer screen, which read, "To my loving wife, subject, I've arrived. Date, October the 17th. I know you're surprised to hear from me, but they have computers here now. And you're allowed to send emails to your loved ones. I've just arrived and I've been checked in. I see that everything has been prepared for your arrival tomorrow. Looking forward to seeing you then. Hope your journey is as uneventful as mine. P.S. It's freaking hot down here." I love it. Right. On with the game, which is an important game. They've all been important. This is the one, though. This is the eighth show, and you win the title of octochamp and come back to our finals. I think you'd probably come back anyway, but it would be nice to come back as an undefeated chap. You've got to beat Steve Jepp. Steve is from Woburn, is that? Woburn Sands in Buckinghamshire.
That's right, yeah.
He's a support worker. His favourite place on earth is Italy. And his ambition is to buy his parents a retirement home. Is that here or in Italy?
Probably be Spain or Greece if my dad goes.
Spain or Greece, yeah. But you like Italy, okay? Yes. His hobbies include rugby, football, flotation tanks. And this gentleman, Steve, claims to be the world's worst DIYer. Are you pretty useless to that, are you?
I'm very cack-handed and clumsy.
Well, let's see how you can do against this chap. So we wish them both luck today. Steve and David are playing today.
Well, all of last week our guest was doing lots of whys, why this, why that. So I have a little why, which is this. If he is never lost for words, why is a spell with him in Dictionary Corner just like a long sentence? Joining Dictionary Dolly, Alison Hurd, for some more nine-letter nonsense. He's back, Richard Digens. No, I don't mean it. You know I love you.
Well, that's the last time I run around the northeast with you.
We walked twice. Oh, did we not walk?
No, we ran. I came just behind Paula Radcliffe. We've done that one before.
All right. Let's do this one again then. It's a very important game, as we say, for David. And Steve's going to be doing his best. But first, David, we'll put some letters there.
A vowel, please.
A vowel. Thank you, David. E.
Another vowel.
E.
Oh, and a vowel.
And O.
Consonant, please.
B.
Consonant.
P.
A consonant.
H.
A consonant.
T.
Another consonant, please.
N.
And a final consonant.
And L.
And here's the first clock. David, how do we go there?
Seven.
And Steve?
Just five.
Just the five. Let's hear your five, Steve.
Just phone.
What was that? Phone?
Phone. P-H.
Phone. Oh, yeah. And?
Punching.
Can you spell that?
Yep, P-O-T-H-E-E-N.
Potchin. Mm.
Yeah, is that like a bit like moonshine, isn't it?
Yeah, it's brewed from potatoes.
Yes, that's the
How
one
do you
I know yeah.
about moonshine? That's sort of wild bootleg whiskey, isn't it? Moonshine.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. Naughty.
But Richard wouldn't know about things like that. What have you got there, Richard?
Yes, the crew know why Alice knows about moonshine. Don't worry about that one. there's Phoebe, which is P-H-O-E-B-E.
Mm-hmm. But isn't that just a name?
Phoebe? No, it's...
It's also a bird, a type of bird, a fly-catching bird.
It's a fly-catcher.
Okay, well, David's got off to his usual start. He's got a seven-point lead, and Steve not on the mark, but he's going to put some letters up there right now. There you go, Steve.
Consonant, please, Carol.
Thank you. T.
And a consonant, please.
L.
Vowel.
E.
Vowel.
A.
Consonant, please.
C.
Vowel.
U.
Consonant.
T.
Vowel.
I.
And a consonant, please.
And S.
And here's the clock. Steve?
Seven.
Seven, and Dave?
Seven.
You've got seven as well. Steve, we'll have your seven.
Cutlets.
Cutlets?
Yes.
Nice little snack. Cutlets, and Dave?
Elastic.
Elastic. Right,
nice.
There you
yeah,
go. They're both good sevens, and that puts Steve on the board. What have we got over there, Richard?
There is an eight. Stretching it one more. Stretch. Lattices.
Lattices. Yep. Mm. Okie doke. That's a difficult one to spell, isn't it, Carol? Lattices?
No, it's not difficult for us.
She's good, that girl.
Yeah, get me salad.
Right, we've got a 14 playing a 7, and David will choose the letters.
A file, please.
A.
Another one.
I.
A file.
E.
Consonant, please.
G.
Consonant.
C.
A consonant.
T.
Another consonant, please.
S.
And a consonant.
D.
And a vowel, please.
And O.
And here's that clock. David, what do you have?
Eight.
Eight. Right. Steve?
Just seven.
Just seven. What's your seven?
Cagiest.
Cagiest. Yeah. And David?
It's goodishes again.
Can you spell that?
G-O-D-E-T-I-A-S.
Fantastic.
Goodacious.
Very good. Yeah.
Right, Richard, what do you have?
Yeah, we've got some smaller ones there. Digest, that's what I used to call it. It's called cagiest. And there's a nine.
A nine?
Which is a Scotty dog.
A Scotty dog?
Yes.
Yes. Thank you very much, Mr. Digens.
Moving on
to the scores, which are 22 to David. Steve's got seven. Steve, we offer you some more letters now. There you go.